Hey guys, welcome back to another video update of Hurricane Beryl. Here is the most recent satellite imagery that shows the center of the system clearly in the middle of that dense cloud cover moving westward. Barbados is the closest island to that center, but because the system is moving westward, it is expected to move somewhat to the south of Barbados, between Barbados and Tobago, then entering the Caribbean Sea. I will basically walk you through where we are with this system and give you an idea of what we should be expecting with regard to Hurricane Beryl, which is over the waters of the tropical Atlantic and moving closer and closer to the eastern Caribbean and therefore into the Caribbean Sea. At 5 o'clock, the center of the hurricane was located over 500 kilometers from Barbados. It is moving westward with a central pressure of 960, indicating that it is a very intense system. The lower the pressure, the stronger the system. This is what the most recent track projection looks like. The numbers you see on the left side of the screen really are pinpointing where those black dots on the map are located. The hurricane is already at Category 4, and it is approaching the Windward Islands. There are life-threatening winds, storm surge, and storm surge that is expected. It is predicted to enter the Caribbean by Monday morning and then continue through the afternoon into the Caribbean, staying going into the Central Caribbean during the day on Tuesday. As we can see all the way to the right side of your picture, that yellow circle shows the overcast of that hurricane that is moving westward. It is already at Category 4, which means it is a major hurricane moving toward the west-northwest really, which is just a little bit north of Key West. If you look on the left side, those two lines that are highlighted in red show where the positions are the one at 2 a.m. on the right side shows the 60-hour projection, where the winds are expected to be at about 5 miles per hour now that would characterize it as a Category 3 hurricane as we move to the 72 hours, which takes the center now to the 2 p.m. Or after 2 p.m. on Wednesday. That's when the approach is likely to be much closer to Jamaica. It is anticipated that there will be some weakening of the system as it moves westward because the conditions in the Western Caribbean are not as favorable for development as they have been over the Atlantic and will be in the Eastern Caribbean. However, the exact amount of weakening is uncertain because at the end of this forecast period, the accuracy is likely to fluctuate periodically because it is not as certain the longer the forecast. On Wednesday, the wind speed would then drop to 110 miles per hour, which would be at Category 2. So, even though the center of the system is pinpointed in the middle of the cone, it could be on the right or left side, meaning that by the time it passes us, it could be farther from Jamaica's south coast or over the waters to the north of the country. As a result, there is currently some uncertainty as to exactly where the center will be, but the black dot representing the H at 2 p.m. on Wednesday is showing where the most likely position would be based on the forecast at this time. The minister stated that this is a risk that we have to manage tomorrow morning. First thing in the morning, we'll be able to assess this and determine whether now that it is about entering the Caribbean region and whether there is a threat, we consider it to be so. This could change as we move forward if the center of the system is further from the south coast, moving it more over the Caribbean Sea and away from the land area. That is something that we are hoping we'll see develop over the next day or two. The three main messages we want to convey are that, as of right now, a hurricane of extremely dangerous category is moving into the Western Islands, Windward Island, very dangerous situation especially for the islands of the Eastern Caribbean, Leewards in particular, and that it is a potentially catastrophic hurricane with very strong winds, which could result in a storm surge that could endanger lives, damaging waves, and possibly very heavy rainfall. The third point also indicates that the Windward Islands will experience heavy rainfall and localized rainfall. That is essentially where we are right now in terms of what we are expecting with the system moving closer. We're still hoping that the projections moving forward will show further weakening likely in the Central Caribbean, but it will also show a drift away from the southern coastline, which is the best-case scenario but the worst-case scenario. The fourth point shows that Jamaica is also at risk of that heavy rainfall as the system moves closer and closer to us. Not just the strong winds associated with a hurricane, but all these other complexities with storm surge and landslides, and all these other things that normally come the hazards that come with hurricane activity.